I'm James Segars with the program in Reproductive and Adult Endocrinology with the National Institute of Child Health and Human Development. I'll talk today on our recent report on the economic cost of uterine fibroids. Uterine fibroids are the most common disorder of women. One in two women will develop fibroids prior to the menopause. Specifically, studies have shown that 50% of white women and 80% of black women will develop uterine fibroids. And about 1% of these women will seek care and treatment for uterine fibroids each year. Fibroids affect the uterus or womb. This slide shows a fibroid removed at myomectomy. And as you can see, the tumors grow to be quite large, 12 centimeters, as shown by the ruler on the right. Fibroids cause pain, bleeding, and pelvic pressure. Because of their large size and their symptoms, many women require treatment. There are approximately 30,000 myomectomies and 200,000 hysterectomies performed each year in the United States because of uterine fibroids. As you can see here, because of differences in disease severity and prevalence, black women are much more likely to undergo these procedures than white women. It's also important to note that fibroids affect women who are building their families and becoming pregnant. This slide shows the prevalence of fibroids in women of reproductive age. Age 20 to 40 years old. Again, note that fibroids are more prevalent in black than white women. Because of their involvement in the uterus during pregnancy, there is a significant increase in the number of obstetric complications due to uterine fibroids. For example, cesarean section is increased several fold in women who have fibroids of the uterus during pregnancy. Again, there are other complications as well, as shown on this slide. While there have been several studies that have assessed the societal cost of uterine fibroids, no studies have previously examined the associated obstetrical cost of uterine fibroids on an annual basis. Therefore, the goal of our study was to estimate the annual cost of uterine fibroids, including obstetric-related cost and pregnancy-related cost, as well as direct and indirect cost. We used available published data sources to estimate the annual cost of uterine fibroids, and our analysis was based on the assumption that 0.92% of women aged 25 to 40 would seek treatment during a year, and approximately 94% of those women would undergo treatment during that 1 year. The key points and figures are shown on this slide. The point estimates were broad, because the sources we used to estimate the range reported wide differences in cost. We converted all dollars to 2010 dollars, and these estimates, of course, illustrate the fact that uterine fibroids result in a considerable expense to the United States healthcare system. Some noteworthy points are that pregnancy-related costs range from 0.2 to $7.7 billion a year. The largest contributor was lost work, which was $1.5 to $17.2 billion per year, and the annual direct costs, which includes surgery, medical treatment, hospitalization, and outpatient treatment, was $4.1 to $9.1 billion per year, and the total cost due to uterine fibroids we estimated to be $5.8 to $34.4 billion per year. While our study was a cost estimate, it's interesting to compare these estimates with other diseases that affect women and the associated cost. At the high end of the estimate, fibroids are one of the most expensive disorders of women. Even at the lower end of $5.8 billion per year, the cost is considerable. Our results emphasize the need to develop new effective treatments for uterine fibroids, because in our sensitivity analysis we found that if one could reduce the number of women undergoing hysterectomy each year to minimize that number, we would save 25% of the associated healthcare costs due to uterine fibroids. Thank you for your attention.